I wanted to talk a little bit. Last week we reported on what was going on with the blackouts, rolling blackouts in California.
Oh boy!
Here and we go remember again. We talked about that. And you know, it's interesting because I found an article in that that liberal rag, the Wall Street Journal.
Oh, the Wall Street Journal! Hooray!
Yeah, hooray! Yes, exactly. Pointing out that PG&E's big blackout is only the beginning; that this is going to continue to be an ongoing issue around the country, but particularly in coastal states and states that have extreme weather or that have a lot of forests, that have a lot of water. Mm-hmm. This is in a sense going to start becoming the new normal.
Because here's the thing. I think we should also clarify, what does that mean by the new normal? Well, new normal, more droughts, more forest fires, more super hurricanes, more polar vortexes, more extreme shifts in weather, which can cause a lot of problems, such as damaging infrastructure, ruining crops, causing disease to spread rapidly, causing people to evacuate their towns and cities because it's no longer cost-effective to rebuild the infrastructure or town if it's going to constantly get hit by these superstorms. This is a problem we're going to have to deal with as a species, because this isn't an American issue. This is a human issue.
It is.
And climate change, look, and just in my opinion, is a real threat, and we have to address it now more than ever.
And the fact that there are going to be people, particularly people who don't have the money to create housing, who don't have the money to keep bouncing back, number one, but who also don't have the money to create housing that can withstand climate change, as we've talked about, very likely will be coming toward the Midwest and the Great Lakes and Chicago. And if we have good schools for them, well, maybe that can be a positive thing. But that's why I think we do have to, here in Chicago, being investing in infrastructure.
Oh yeah, we should, because again, just a little off topic, because I want us to talk about the story. There was one point when the polar vortex hit the city of Chicago, Lakeshore Drive was shut down, and that's like a major artery in the city of Chicago. It's a major highway, and the very fact that it got shut down because the extreme cold was basically, crippling the bridge, causing some infrastructure problems. I'm concerned about the next one or some other storm that could hit it, because nothing is safe right now in this country. The United States hasn't invested in its power infrastructure, in its cities, and its roads, and its railways, and it's a problem if we don't really take the threat of climate change as a threat that it is. But take it away with the story that's happening with PG&E's blackout.
The thing is, it was commentary from Wall Street Journal basically noting this is just going to be the start. Mm-hmm. We're going to be seeing a lot more of this, and of course, when we look at things like the power grid, we are dependent on electricity. I mean, look at this studio. How many outlets and plugs and do we have in this studio?
We have a lot,
and this goes to businesses. And there are businesses, people who have lost their businesses even after a few days because they simply are not going to be able to recover from that sort of thing. So that is a real issue. But another issue that's coming up was brought up. Was in the New York Times a story about how different counties that are affected by natural disasters get different levels of help from the government. Mm-hmm. And it's not always clear whether this help is connected to actual need or actual damage or whether there are other forces at play.
Right.
And so, for example, this article in the New York Times pointed out that FEMA was doing home buyouts. Where they will go in and they will, if there's a whole area that seems to be a floodplain, they will go in, buy out the owners, and will demolish the home so that the homeowners can move on. But apparently, you can't apply directly to the federal government for this. You have to work through county agencies.
Okay.
And some counties have more resources than others for matching people up. And then there seems to be some cases in which it is the poor communities that get targeted for the buyout. And they said, now you can go on your way.
Something that we're all too familiar with
here in
the city of Chicago.
Something that we're all too familiar with. So there are some areas that are getting the assistance maybe to help them stay in their communities, or they're getting more assistance. But there are other cases where this is, call it maybe an ethnic cleansing or a class cleansing that's going on without there being an accountability system of pulling back. Okay, why did this community get the buyout, and this community, which is actually in more danger, did not? why we want this community to be dismantled and this community not, when there isn't, when one community may have more of a risk than the other. There's not yeah. that kind of one standard, because again, this is going through county agencies.
This has a lot to deal with the fact that if certain neighborhoods lack power or influence, or if it's a low income neighborhood, yeah. it's the first to go on the chopping block. And this is a little bit unrelated, but if we look at the amount of times we've covered here at Heartlands Media about gentrification happening in the city of Chicago, the majority of neighborhoods that are being gentrified right now by large real estate developers are predominantly on the south and west side neighborhoods of Chicago. Now, of course, climate change has nothing to do with that. This is just, but just hearing how climate change is actually causing this situation to happen with this, with the people in these communities in California, it has the same MO, because here you have the government and their people and the people who buy them, basically their lobby groups, basically saying, okay, you know, you could do this. Let's get rid of some of these communities because no one's going to care.
And you have multiple layers of government.
Yeah.
So it's not just one shot to a federal agency. It is, you know, shots to county agencies and whatnot. And heaven knows how those are managed. And many areas don't have robust regulatory agencies.
Right.
There are areas where there's very little funding for regulatory agencies, so they're just not going to be as efficient. So mm-hmm. We're talking about federal funds that are being dispersed in ways that there isn't a whole lot of transparency and accountability, and
right.
that needs to stop, particularly in light of ever-increasing weather oddities that are causing this kind of devastation.
Absolutely.